Hey there, this is Tim Verdow, and thank you so much for checking out my VirtualReel review. Now, in a nutshell, VirtualReel allows you to create VR videos, virtual reality videos, from your own videos, from built-in videos that are in the software implemented. You can use your panorama photos, you can create text VR videos, a lot of possibilities. I'm going to show you everything within a second. But before I do so, I want to mention that there is a link in the description of this video that will redirect you to my website where you can find more information and also where I'm going to give you some extra bonuses if you pick up VirtualReel through my link. And one of those bonuses is Virtual Home Tour that allows you to create virtual home tours from 360 images. Very cool software. Going to give it completely free and a lot more bonuses as well if you pick up VirtualReel through my link. All right, let's dive into this and let me show you how VirtualReel works. So once you log into the software, this is what you will see. And this is the main menu that you're seeing right here where you can start creating your videos. Now, as you can see, there are different types of videos. You can start creating VR videos from scratch. You can create them from regular videos, from panoramic images. You can create then spin videos from VR videos, and you can create VR videos from text. Now, to show you a few examples, I'm going to open the sales page so that you can see what is possible. So let me open one in here, and I've put down the volume, but here you can see a video, and when I hover with my mouse, look what happens. I can simply scroll through this video, and this is 360. And I can zoom out, as you can see here. And this is one of the videos that you can create. Here is another one. This is a panoramic image. So this is from a panoramic image on your phone, for example. You can create stuff like this, where you can add videos, where you can add text layers, etc. And everything, I can zoom out, I can zoom in, as you can see. Everything is created from a panoramic image. And this next example is being created from a normal video here. You can add these things in your video. Videos inside of your videos, text. And you can see this is a video layer, 360 video in the background. Text layers again. So this is another one. Here's another normal video. Let me open this one. This is a spin video that you can create here. So this spins automatically, so you do not have to move your mouse, but you can create these scenes. And as you can see, this is a 360 background image, and the image, the video is spinning here. And that's basically what you can create with these different types of videos. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the first option because I think everything can be explained inside of this video. So when I create one from scratch, I have the ability to choose from the VR videos. Now, these VR videos are built in, so you can choose from a full library here of background videos. So let's say you want to use one of these videos, then you can simply select the video here, and now it will load the video here in the video editor for you. As you can see right now, it's being added here inside of this video editor. Now, if it's a playing video, it will also start playing within a few seconds. But from here, you can add your text layers, your video layers, your image layers. So as you can see here at the top, this is the VR library, this button. And with this button, you can decide what appears in the background here of your video. Now, then we have the other elements as well here, which are the text layers, the media library, the character library. That was the word I was looking for, a character. You can add the characters to your video as well. And as you can see right now, the video is already playing in the background. Now, if you want to add a media, so I'm going to start with a media, you can choose from the library here at the left side. So it has a built-in library of images, and you can search for images as well. It has a library of videos as well, or you have your own media library where you can upload your own video. So if you want to play your own video inside of this 360 VR video, you can upload your own video as well. In this case, I'm going to use one of these videos. So this is a video. When you click on it, it will be added to your 360 video. Now you need to make this a little bit smaller because the actual video, the end result, will be zoomed in a lot. So you need to make your video smaller because when you see the actual 360 video, it will be zoomed in a lot more. So here is my video playing inside of this 360 environment. And now I can add a text layer to it as well. So when I click on text here at the top, I can add a text layer as well. And it will be added in here, as you can see, enter your text here. So I can change the text here when I go here to the, when I select my text here, I can change this as well, or I can double click this. I guess I can type this. Yes, now I can type this. So at go to the forest, for example, and I add this in here. Then you can decide what kind of colors you like to have the font. You can add a background as well. So if you want to have a background with the font, you can choose a color from here. And as you can see here, you can center this text. When you click on center, it will be centered inside of this box. And this is my first element that I've added to the scene. So I can make this video a little bit bigger so that it also matches the text in here. And of course, go to the forest does not make any sense, but you got the idea, right? You can add all different kind of videos and images inside of here. So if you want to add another media, you simply click on media library and you add another video. So let's say we want to add this waterfall as well. You click on this and now this other video will be added to your video as well. And I can add this to the right side, or if I can add this to the center of the screen to this 360 scene in here. And now I can add my second text layer here on top of it or at the bottom. So this is my second text. I click on add text and now my second text layer will be added to my 360 video. And again, I can give this a nice background color as well so that we can read the text very well. And then there's also another option to add characters to your video. So here you have different kind of emojis that you can add to your video, but you can also choose to add 3D characters like you're seeing right here. All those characters can be added to your video. So when you click on this character, it will be added to your video and you can start editing this inside of this video. Now, once you're done, once you have added all your elements, you can also decide to add your audio. So there's different kind of audio. So there's a music library in here that you can choose from, that you can add to your video. But you're also able to use the robo voice where you can add text to speech. So you can add your text here at the left side and you can choose from different languages. So these are the languages that are supported right now. So that's English, British, Indian, Australian English, and Welsh English, and French, German, and Spanish. And from here, you can choose whatever kind of voice you would like, from Joey, Justin, Matthew, Joanna, Kendra, Kimberly, or Sally. So if you like, you can add this to your scene as well. And of course, there's also another possibility to upload your own audio. So when you're in here, you can upload your own audio and you can add that to your 360 video. Another option is to add your own intro and outro video. So you can upload your own intro video and your own outro video that will be rendered in front of your video and at the end of your video. And then once you save your project, you first always need to save your project in order to preview your project. If you would like to see how this will look like, you first need to save your project and then you can click on this button preview and this will give you a preview of your current scene. And it says the preview you see does not include animation and is not the exact video, but a screenshot of the VR video that will render. So you will not see a moving video, but you will get a good idea of how everything will be rendered. So there it is. As you can see here, it says go to the forest. This is the video that we added to our scene, right? So what you see here, this palm tree, this will be playing in the background. This will be moving as a 3D video. And here is the other one with the video and to your text here. These are all the elements that we have added to our video. And as you can see, I can zoom in. I can, here, when I zoom out with my mouse, I can zoom out through the scene. And this is 360 video that will be rendered that will create videos like I just showed you here. When we replay this video, this is a video, you see, that can be changed. And when you add multiple videos here, you can see the second video in here. And this can be changed when the end result is there. So if you're ready, you can click on render, but let me click on settings here. Because in the settings, you can decide the video duration here. You can decide to have this 30 seconds, 60, or how long you like to have them. Make sure to check on the sales page if there is a limit. I'm not sure right now. And the image video opacity, not sure what it is. Probably this will be the image opacity of the images that are on top of your video. Now, once you're done, make sure again to save your project in here. And then once that is done, you can click on render in here. First, you need to give your project a name. So this is Tim's project. And then once you're done, of course, need to save this again and then click on render. And now your video will be added to the queue and your video will be rendered in the background. Now, keep in mind that this takes a little while. This will not be done within 5 minutes. This will cost a little longer, probably. Also depending, of course, on how long your video is. And this was the example of the video from scratch. As you can see here, this is Tim's project. As you can see here, it now says downloading resources here. So it's downloading the videos that we added to our scene, etc. And now it says awaiting rendering. So now it's going to render the video for me. Now, the same videos can be created with VR video from a regular video. This is all the examples that I showed you on the sales page, but it works really similar. And also from a panoramic image where you use your panoramic image as a background. One thing that I want to show you is another example here, create VR video from text. So what you can do with this style of video is you can add your text here, for example, and then you click on create. And now you need to choose the background that will be the background of your video. You know, when you're spinning your video, you need to choose a VR background again. So again, you can pick one of those here that you see. So let's say we want to use this one. Then it's going to create this background for us. And as you can see here, this now here is a whole green area. We don't see any video. And that is because this is only the text field. So when I zoom in here, you can see that the video that we just chosen as the background, you can see that will be used as the VR background, but this green area will be used for our text video. So here we have our text. When we go to the text element, and again here, so this was the text element, right? We click on text and now we can change the text. So we can center this text again. We can type more text if we like to, or we can add this to another line. But another thing that we also can do is we can go to the media library and change the background for this text element. So when I go to the media library, I can say, for example, you can choose from images, videos, and your own media. But let's say you go to videos, you can also say, okay, now I want to have this waterfall here. I want to have that as a background in the text layer. So now it's going to add this video as a background in here. And you don't see that here in this image, but look at the end result here at the bottom. This is how it will look like. So your text will be on top of this waterfall here. And I'm not sure why it's not showing in the background. I think I saw this before that it was added to the background. So let's choose another one. Yeah, here is right now it's being added. So now you can see this is one of the scenes that's playing. But when we look here at the bottom here, here we can see there is a plus icon, and when we click this plus icon, we can create a complete new scene. So when we go back here to our text, we can add another text line. So this is our second scene, and we can center this text again. And now we can choose to have a different video background. So if we choose, for example, we want to use this video as a background, now this video will be added as a background. So we have two scenes. We have our first scene in here with this background video, and we have a second scene in here with this background video. And then we can create another one by clicking on the plus. We can add a new text line in here. And then again, we can go to the media library and we can add another media behind this text. So this way we have three scenes. We have one, two, three scenes where we can add are different videos. But again, the VR video is still the blue one that we selected at the beginning. And then once you're done, you can add your audio again. You can add your intro and outro again, or your voiceover. Don't forget to save your project. And once you're done, you can click on render and it will render the video for you. Now, once your video is rendered, you can download it. You can upload it to YouTube and then your video will be 360 automatically. Keep in mind, once a video is uploaded to YouTube, it will not be 360 immediately. It will take a little while for YouTube to render and recognize it is a 360 video, but it will be recognized automatically and then your videos will be 360 on YouTube. And that is my review about VirtualReel. And again, if you're interested, there is a link in the description of this video. It will redirect you to my website where you're going to get Virtual Home Tour, my software, for free as a thank you for picking up VirtualReel through my link. You're even going to get some more software, and other cool software that you're going to get also if you pick this up through my link is an alpha QR code account. And this is very cool because here you can create QR codes. When people scan this code, you can redirect them with this code to your VR video. How cool is that? So you can create VR codes, you can put it on tables or wherever you like, and everyone that scans that QR code will be redirected to your VR video on YouTube when you link that to your YouTube video. A lot more bonuses you're going to get here. Make sure you go over them. And when you click on this button, you can decide to go to the sales page, or you can decide to get the bundle deal page where you get the whole funnel. Here, let me go to the pricing. The pricing is also here. So we have the front end. It starts for $47 for the commercial version. And we have all different kind of upgrades. As you can see here, you can go over these. All these upgrades are included in the bundle deal. So if you want to have the whole funnel for a huge discounted price, make sure to check out that special bundle deal, because you're going to get a huge discount. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't yet, if you'd like to see future reviews as well. And please hit that thumbs button so that my video will also bump up in the YouTube search results. I appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in my next review. Talk soon. Bye-bye.